Hey there, Dungeoneers! Welcome to my GODZERKER Siren build guide in Borderlands 3. This is the build that I am using to run all content in the game, and it is by far the most fun build that I have found for Amara. Now, while it may not be the absolute best build for rushing bosses, it still manages to handle most content in the game while also being extremely fun to play and dealing massive amounts of AoE damage. So let's get right on into the build and I'm gonna show you how it works. Alright guys, so here we are in our skill tree and I'm gonna be showing you what we are running for this build. So first things first, we maxed out Anima because dealing increased damage over time and having increased duration on your status effects are going to be one of the main ways you stay alive with this build. Not only are you doing massive damage over time to all the enemies, later down in the skill tree you are going to be doing life stealing whenever you steal or deal damage with your weapon that is elemental. So it just makes sense to be doing as much elemental damage as possible. Now, the reason I don't take these ones here, this one here is kind of interesting because people think that it's doing 8% increased damage, but it's not. This is converting a portion of your damage into your action skill element, which I don't really like that much because sometimes I need the damage to stay the way it is. If I'm using a type of, you know, a certain type of gun and the enemies are resistant to it, I don't want to be losing out on damage. And if I'm going to be needing a certain type of element, I'm just going to be using that type of elemental gun. So I don't really use this at all. And then the increased weapon handling and accuracy, I mean, most of the weapons I use in this build are really inaccurate anyway, so I don't think this is going to make a big difference. But, I mean, you could always throw some points in there if you like. We max out Tempest because increased elemental damage, I mean, it speaks for itself. You need as much elemental damage as possible for this build. We skip over Illuminated Fist because we're not meleeing. And then we go into Wildfire. Whenever Amara applies a status effect to an enemy, it has a chance to spread to nearby enemies. This is a big AoE build, so having more AoE elements is not going to hurt at all, and it's just going to be more healing for you. And then I do put points into Dread because using Grasp in this build, it's going to be on a very low cooldown. So having 15% increased gun damage to Grasp targets is just going to really, really help you out. And then of course, whenever you kill a Grasped enemy, your weapon is reloaded. Now, a lot of the weapons I'm using in this build reload whenever you get a crit anyway. But, I mean, that's not going to hurt. I mean, because you're going to be healing while you're dealing damage, any reloading that you're doing is going to be downtime on your healing. So you're really going to want to make sure you're reloading as little as possible, and Dread just kind of helps out with that. On here, Indiscriminate, Amara's bullets that damage enemies have a chance to ricochet and deal decreased damage to other nearby enemies. And then ricochet chance and damage are increased if the target is affected by phase grasp. So of course, since we're going to be phase grasping over and over again, and we are going to be using the linked phase grasp, basically whenever you phase grasp one enemy, about 5 or 6 nearby enemies are all going to be taking damage from you hitting them anyway, and they're going to be dealing a lot of damage, guys, because if you phase grasp a really tanky enemy, and then it links to a bunch of weak enemies, even if they're only taking a percentage of the damage, you're going to be killing them with basically the link anyway. So I max out Indiscriminate. I don't see the point in not taking the point in Deep Well. I mean, it's a free 20% increase magazine size with one skill point. Why not? And then I do have Catharsis on here. Whenever Amara triggers an elemental effect on an enemy, when that enemy dies, that enemy explodes, dealing her attuned element damage along with any other element that is currently inflicted on that enemy. So this is just going to give you more AoE damage. Now, if you don't want to put the points in there, you could put them into the accuracy. You could realistically put them into infusion as well if you really like it. But I'm just not really a fan. This is what I've been running. Of course, we max out sustainment. Amara deals lifesteal whenever gains lifesteal whenever you deal damage that is elemental with your weapon. This is basically mandatory for this build because this build is very glass cannony. It deals massive amounts of damage, but it is fairly, you know, weak when it comes to being tanky. So any lifesteal you can get is great because you have so much elemental damage going on at one time that you can pretty much just, if you're running low on health, you just hide behind the wall and your elemental damage will just heal you right back up to full and you can get right back out in the fight. I got 2 points in Conflux here. I can't remember if I put a point in. No, I didn't. This is just from my class mod. Whenever Amara applies a status effect to an enemy, she gains a chance to randomly electrocute, ignite, or melt that enemy. I haven't done a lot of testing with this one yet, so if you can figure out if this one means that you get free instant kills on like a 20% chance whenever you hit somebody, I mean, this could actually be, end up being a fantastic skill. Leave a comment down below if it is working properly. But I feel like I've had points in this before, and it doesn't seem to really just randomly kill enemies when I'm hitting them. So maybe I'm wrong about that, but it just seems kind of a weird skill, so I don't put any points in it. And then, of course, we put points into Forceful Expression. Amara's guns deal bonus elemental damage based on your action skill element. You can run shock, or you can run fire with that. So, I mean, having free fire damage is not going to hurt whatsoever. So I put a point into that as well. And then for my active skills, I am using, of course, Ties That Bind. Amara phase grass a target, and then enemies near the grass target are linked, and any damage dealt to them is shared between all other linked targets. This is, of course, absolutely insane for doing AoEs, because you're also going to be pulling them in with Allure, which is going to allow more people to get caught by the link, which is going to be doing more AoE damage, which are also exploding and applying your AoE effects from this, which is also causing increased damage over time, which is also healing you, and it's just an absolute, you know, craziness, the amount of AoE damage you're dealing. And then I have a point in Soulfire, because the last thing I was farming was flesh monsters, so having incendiary damage, of course, is doing better against that. If you are going against monsters that are mainly shielding, for example, you're going against a lot of Malawan, or perhaps you're even just going up against the Iridians, take this off and just use the plain shock damage. Now, on the next tree over, now, if you go over into this tree here, you can make your character a lot tankier, but I like doing a lot more damage, so I went into this tree here, the Mystical Assault tree. So, first thing we're going to be taking a look at here is 5 points in Violent Tapestry. Applying a status effect gains Amara a stack of rush. Activating your action skill consumes all rush stacks. For every stack of rush consumed, Amara's status effect chance is temporarily increased. There is a way that you can actually use this with Phase Grasp, and I'm going to show you that once we're done talking about the build. You can actually get this up to 99 stacks and then get basically 30% increased effect chance, which basically means you get free elemental damage. Like, it's really, really good. I have 2 points in this one here because why not? Reload speed is always fantastic. And I didn't see the point in having extra ones of these because you are not dealing damage with your action skill. So do no harm is not going to be super useful. No points in Alacrity because reload speed for every stack of rush. If you are using the call weapons like I'm using, you're really not going to be reloading. And you really want to be reloading as little as possible with this build, because dealing damage is the way that you're surviving, because it's giving you lifesteal. So increasing your reload speed is basically increasing, you know, doing something you really don't want to be doing. So I didn't put any points in there. Put in Transcend because after using your action skill, not only are you going to be getting the 15% bonus damage from the previous tree, but now you're also going to get an additional 27% increased crit damage and 38% increased accuracy, which is going to allow you to hit those crits, which is going to allow you to do more damage, and you are going to be sharing that damage with all nearby targets, and it all kind of snowballs together. Put 5 points in Restless. This gives you 25% cooldown reduction on your action skill. And this is crazy, guys, because with this on, my Phase Grasp is on around an 8 to 10 second cooldown. Okay, 8 to 10 second cooldown. That means you are pretty much always able to Phase Grasp every single badass in the area and just AoE farm massive amounts of mobs. Now, I skipped over Ascendant because I'm really not using any of these action skill augments, so I didn't really worry about it too much. I skipped over From Rest because charge time and fire rate, I mean, it's kind of useful and it's good on the boss rushing build, but realistically, I don't see the point in using fire rate and charge time when there are more important things in the tree. I put 3 points in a Laid Bear. Enemies take increased damage from all sources for a few seconds after being damaged by her action skill. Of course, this is going to be another 25% damage to the enemies that you have Phase Grasped. And because the other enemies that are linked are taking damage from your action skill, they are also going to be taking 25% increased damage. So you can see how this Phase Grasp is really going to start rolling up the damage to all nearby enemies and allowing you to AoE farm these mobs. And then last but not least, I had 2 skill points left over. You can put them into the improved fire rate if you're using a gun with a really high fire rate, and perhaps you want that. But I put it into Wrath because it is just a straight up 13% increased gun damage. And an additional 13% increased gun damage after using your action skill. So another damage modifier rolling up that phase grass damage. And guys, I cannot stress this enough, okay? If it took me a full 30 bullets to kill a badass without phase grasping them, when they're phase grassed, I'm looking at maybe 5 or 6 bullets. Okay, it literally mows these guys down. And not only that, but when you're doing that, you're killing all nearby enemies. It is absolutely insane for AoE farming. Now, if you're going to be killing bosses, guys, the one thing you might want to switch up for the boss is switching this Ties That Bind skill, switching it with this Phase Cast skill so you can get a little bit more of the rush stacks. Now, that is what I would normally say if I didn't figure out the secret to getting 99 rush stacks with Phase Grasp. And I'm going to show you that right now. So, a lot of you may know that if you don't phase grasp a target, it'll actually take the skill back off cooldown. Now, if I were to cast it again, and you look in the bottom there, I gain 14 rush stacks. Now I'm at 28. Now I'm at 42. Now I'm at 56 rush stacks. Now I'm at 70. And you can just keep pressing this all the way until you go up to 99 rush stacks. Now, I know what you're thinking. I don't have a lot of rush stack increasing ability, or I don't have a lot of rush stack using passive skill trees in there. So why would you need to farm your way up to 99 rush stacks? Well, for the whole reason this is called the GODZERKER Guide. That is a hellfire. That is not my class mod. But anyway, because of this, the Spectral Phase Zerker, on action skill use, Amara gains your max rush stack count, but they decay over time. You gain 3% increased damage and 10% action skill cooldown rate based on the number of rush stacks. Now, the cooldown rate isn't going to matter too much, but that means you are, of course, getting a free 300% increased weapon damage while grinding bosses, because while you're grinding regular mobs, you might as well just use one phase grasp, shoot them down, and have that AoE damage go out. But when you're going against bosses, you can't phase grasp them. So what are you going to do? You're going to sit there and you're going to phase grasp over and over again until you're at 99 stacks, get your 300% increased weapon damage and 1000% action skill cooldown rate, which is not really useful because you're not going to phase grasp them. But I'm just going to use that and we are going to absolutely melt through the bosses, guys. Now, I'm going to try and figure out if I can get this gun screen working properly, because this is definitely like not looking correctly. I don't really know what's going on with my thing here. Thanks for ruining my video here, Scream, but for my weapons, I have a binary cutsman. Now, the cutsman is probably the strongest gun in this build, guys, because it deals insane amounts of damage over time. As you can see, it shoots out sort of a tripwire-looking effect of bullets, but what's important is those can rapid-fire hit enemies with big hitboxes, such as Grave Ward. And if you look at the gun damage, it's 1,800 damage rapid-firing. Like, it's really, really good. So I've been using that for most of my boss farming, as well as a Liuta. I mean, it's a Liuta. It speaks for itself. Like, it's really not that hard to figure out. You shoot the Liuta and bosses melt. Now, I do have a Rowan's Call. I have been absolutely loving this gun. This is what I'm using for most content, is the Rowan's Call, because I have a radiation one. And whenever I apply a radiation effect, it's doing more AoE damage. If you don't know about the radiation damage, it'll basically allows you to cause AoE damage over time to nearby enemies, as well as, because it's a Rowan's Call, it is critical hits returning 2 bullets to your magazine and ricocheting 2 bullets to nearby enemies. It's absolutely insane. And then I have a Crossroad, just because why not? I'm using a Roid Ward, which is a really not good shield, because it just happens to be the only shield I picked up that was moderately decent, so I haven't really got a good shield going yet. Of course, you need the GODZERKER. It's not called the GODZERKER build for nothing. I have a really crappy grenade. And then this is also super important, guys. This is the Last Stand Auto Aisle, okay? It's absolutely fantastic. Restores 18% of your maximum health after killing an enemy. Regenerate 149 health per second. Increase your max health and gain temporary invulnerability when health drops below 50%. Like I said, this is a glass cannon build, and therefore you're going to have glass cannon health. If you are not living, you are going to be having a bad time. So any sort of shield that will really keep you alive is going to do absolutely fantastic for you in the long run. Now, that's all I really wanted to show you for the build, guys. So I know you're looking forward to the gameplay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to kick it over to some Circle of Slaughter, let you guys watch the gameplay there. I already showed you the Vile Ward gameplay. Or Vile Ward? I already showed you the Grave Ward video at the very beginning of this guide, so I'm going to kick it over to them. Hopefully you enjoyed this video, and if you like this build, don't forget to subscribe for more Borderlands content and like the video so we can get this video up on those search rankings. Thank you all so much for watching, and I hope you enjoy the footage. Peace out.
Ready for a fight.